We welcome all our guest presenters at plenary today, but it is my pleasure to introduce our first speaker, who is our beloved patron, Dr. Don Matera. Donato Francisco Matera was born in 1936 in the Western Native Township, where modern-day Westbury, west of Johannesburg, now stands. His father was an Italian, while his mother was a Setswana-speaking local woman. Now, life in Johannesburg black settlements at that time offered youngsters like Don Matera very little choice. To follow the moral upstanding path expected by the children of Christians and go to school, or to be swept up in the tempting, glamorous life of mobsters. At boarding school, and he is very much our child, he went to a boarding school in Durban, and he was an altar boy in the Catholic Church. But when he returned to Sophia Town, where he grew up, he was lured to the ugly side of social existence. He was soon heading a gang, the Vultures, and he took a few attempts on his life to convince him that there was more in life than just hustling. Turning over a new leaf heralded a new beginning for Matera. A decision that birthed the emergence of the poet, the journalist, the motivational speaker, and the community leader whom later generations would come to know and love, the Don Matera that we love as our patron. The first port of call was a liberation struggle, where as a member of the African National Congress, the Youth League, he stirred things mostly with his pen. This unfortunately soon attracted the attention of the apartheid authorities, who responded with banning orders and house arrests, especially from 1973 to 1982. For those years, he was under house arrest. However, with ink in his veins, it would be very difficult to abide by the banning orders, and he continually fell foul of the law. However, now we can acknowledge that his contribution, our patron's contribution to journalism, remains legendary. When he was not writing himself, he taught others the rudiments of the trade. And as it was a Kadi school run by the Weekly Mail, forerunner of the Mail and Guardian, as a chief training officer there, he helped mold the career of many journalists, among them the Sunday Times editor, Mondile Makanya, and Ferial Hafiji, who is no longer with the Mail and Guardian, but with City Press. Such is his relationship with today's journalists that when he frowns on their writing indiscretions, he spares no one, and ironically receives praise from the very people that he's taken to task. When Matera speaks, his audiences are left spellbound, the trance getting more intense when he recites his poems. His anthology, Azania Love Songs, and other works have won him awards. His autobiography, Memory is a Weapon, won him the Steve Biko Prize. He holds an honorary doctorate in literature from the then University of Natal. Donato Francisco Matera is one of the most fascinating characters in the history of South Africa, and we say this from the bottom of our hearts. You are to us one of the most fascinating characters in South Africa. Your own transformation from the life of a street hustler to that of a respected journalist, a writer, an intellectual, and a member of the community stands as a metaphor for the transformation of child and youth care workers in respect of the many children that we work with. Many of them come from the same kind of challenging background, but believe that there's a vision and a future for them, just like you. You are a proud example. He has, over the years, made a remarkable contribution to the fight against apartheid and the liberation of our society. He is revered as a leader who has helped usher in the new era of a united, just, and democratic society. At the age of 76, this gentle stalwart devotes much of his time to the youth in his community and to developing a spiritual life at his local mosque. But more than that, to us, he contributes his time to the development of the child and youth care workers and the youth that are associated with us in the child and youth care field. He is our beloved patron, Dr. Don Matera, and we call you onto the stage to share with us today.
You can only do it by giving yourself to human beings, helping them work and caring for children, giving them what they don't get from their own parents. So this organization is not an organization. It is the will of God. Once you believe that you have been chosen, ukhethiwe, udimo ukhethiwe, for udira tiro ena. There's no job like this. Jesus, peace be on his name, says, when I was hungry, you fed me. When I was naked, you clothed me. When I was disconsolate of spirit, you comforted me. When I was in prison, you visited me. And the guy said that, hey, Rabbi, when did we do these things for you? He says, we will do it for the least of my creation. It is the same that you have done it to me. So much eternal. Discover, you guys are busy with heavy cargo. To work for children is heavy cargo. The Holy Quran says, on the day of judgment, those who have harmed the children, God will say to them, why did you harm me? So guys, you of NACCW, you hold the key to the kingdom of God. You hold the key. Governments can't do everything. Politicians can't do everything. We are the people. We have the power to change this country through compassion. There is no other thing. Tsidisano, Tuso, Hofebana, Hobayatabele, lead them. But let them also lead you. Blessed is the child that leads the parents. Blessed is the child that knows when to say, teach me, I would like to know. So this organization, to me, is a way of life. Kibbutzim, impilo, maulana le organization yazi ukuthi kwenza umsebenzi wakho uThixo Somandla ngempela kuyakudinga. So I don't have much words today. The words will come. Let us halt this quibbling of reform and racial preservation, saying who belongs to which tribe and to which nation. Let the children decide, for it is their world. We are here on this earth for a purpose. We are running this race. On your mark, get set, ready. Before you go, turn around.